down, taking y'all out of class, right? I will say this, the first person that I met when I came to St. Howard was Coach. And Coach actually was the first person to paddle me back when I was in ninth grade. So I'm a product of all the men that are here today. And I want y'all to, I'm sure y'all understand, and women who are here, that y'all understand how fortunate you all are to be at this school. I'm going to tell you a little bit about myself. I grew up in New Orleans. I went to school out in New Orleans East, and then I came here to St. Aug in ninth grade. Actually, right before that, I went to Holy Cross for a year. I actually got expelled from Holy Cross for fighting. So I got in 4 fights, and I got expelled. So each one of them got 1 disciplinary write-up. I got 4. And a lot of it was race-related. There was a lot of negative words that were being used to me, and I didn't know how to handle it. So all I did was fight, right? So I got expelled, and I came here. Luckily, I got an opportunity to come here. And when I came here, it was an interesting experience for me, because it was actually probably the first time I was around all black males, and it really changed my life. My father passed away when I was 3 years old. He used to play for the New Orleans Saints from 1971 to 1975. And I grew up with a lot of women in my family, and I did not have males around me. I played some sports and stuff like that. I mean, I had a couple coaches here and there, but for the most part, on a daily basis, I didn't have a male around until I got to St. Aug. So this school is very, very important to me. And seeing you all in your ties and sitting up straight and paying attention, that's what I love to see. When I left St. Aug, I went to the University of New Orleans. I was actually going out to Notre Dame, but I passed that up and stayed local. I went to UNO. I graduated in marketing and management. And then after that, I went and worked for the New Orleans Zephyrs. Y'all know the New Orleans Zephyrs, right? Baseball team. What happened with the Zephyrs, I started off as an intern. So I got an opportunity to work there. And I got that opportunity because I was playing basketball with the general manager at UNO, where I was going to school. And, you know, I can play a little bit. I'm not scoring 30 points or whatever, but I do all the things that people don't want to do, the rebounds, the steals, the assists, all that, the X-factor type stuff. And he said, Sonny, if you work as hard as you play, I want you on my team. And that's exactly what happened. So I went and did an internship with them for a year. And then because of how hard I worked, they offered me the director of operations position with the Zephyrs. And this was right when Hurricane Katrina hit. So I was managing about $2 million worth of damage to the stadium literally a year after I got out of college. And anybody can tell you, having a good paying job right after you get out of college can be rare, and having that much responsibility. And it was a learning curve for me, but, you know, I wanted to soak everything up. So I was there early, and I left late. And because of that hard work, I got the opportunity to work for the owner of the Saints, Tom Benson. Y'all know who Tom Benson is?
Yeah.
All right. Well, Tom Benson owns the New Orleans Saints. If you don't know, he's from New Orleans. Made a lot of money in accounting and investments. He bought the New Orleans Saints for about $70 million, and now it's upwards of probably $1.2 billion+. And he has some financial institutions, too. Well, I got that opportunity because his secretary knew the secretary over at the New Orleans Zephyrs, the GM secretary. And he said, oh, I'm looking for somebody to be my chief aide, to go with me everywhere, travel, and help him and Mr. Benson out his wife. So the secretary with the Zephyr said, "I got the perfect guy for you. His name is Sonny."
Adonis Brothers Home, please report to the office. Adonis Brothers Home, please report to the office.
She said, "His name is Sonny. He's a hard worker. Why don't you interview him?" So that's what I did. I got my resume together, updated, went over there. I had four meetings until I met with Mr. Benson, and I passed all four of those. And he was actually looking for somebody that was about around the age of 40, from what I was, and had some experience, a lot more experience than I did. Well, I was 25 at the time, and I was the only person that got interviewed. So for me, that said a lot about what I was doing in my preparation for that opportunity, right? The preparation plus opportunity equals success. And so I remember he slipped over, he said, "This is how much you're gonna get paid." And it was the most I had gotten paid. It wasn't, you know, anything too big, but it was the most I had got paid ever. I was 25. I got the opportunity to travel with him pretty much everywhere all over the world for 3 years. And you're talking about private jets, yachts, lobster steaks, everything. Everywhere this billionaire went, I was there. And I got the opportunity to really learn from a lot of the vice president, the VPs, vice president of marketing, vice president of operations, also on the football side, all of the scouts. So I didn't have limited access. I was able to sit in on everything, all the coaches, I mean, everything. And it was a great experience for me. After that, I went and left. I left there and worked and ran the New Orleans Jazz Institute. And I knew nothing about jazz. I couldn't, if you put instruments up, I couldn't tell you what they were at the time. But I wanted to challenge myself, and I wanted kind of personal development. Y'all know what personal development is? It's kind of like, you know, you say, "Hey, I want to be better. I want to be a better person, and I want to learn and just soak up knowledge." And I actually got the opportunity to run the institute. All right? Now, that was also traveling the world. So I had this experience, amazing experience with the Saints, and then this amazing experience with the New Orleans Jazz Institute. And I was like, "Wow, I'm 29 years old, you know. What do I want to do now? What is going to be my impact?" And so I started a program called Son of a Saint. And because my father played for the Saints, it made sense, right? Son of a Saint. And what we do is we mentor boys. Boys join our program between the age of 10 and 13, and they participate till they're 18 years old. All right, we have two boys in the room who are members of our program. We have Trey, or three, I'm sorry. We have Trey, Pam, we have Colin, and Xander. And they actually were in our program before they started at St. Aug. Well, maybe not Colin, but Trey and Xander before they started at St. Aug. We mentor them, we have a clubhouse in Mid-City, but a lot of what we do is really try to provide as much inspiration for them as possible. And I started this program to really help change some of the kids' lives, and I wanted to do it. So I started off with one kid, and then it kept going and going and going, and now we have 50 kids in our program. A lot of our boys have traveled. Did you go to Montreal? Yeah. So going to Montreal for a lot of our boys, it was the first time they got their passport on the plane, the snow, on the metro. They ride horses. Trey has a horse. Each one of them has a horse. They don't tell you that, but they got a horse that they ride. And we do a lot of fun things with them, right? Now, and when they get older, we get them a job, right? When they're 15, they get a job. And we're going to work on support for them for college. So we're there to help support them. Our oldest boy, Julio Bermudez, is on a $20,000 scholarship to Xavier each year. And our next kid that's in line, Alejandro, just got accepted to the University of Tampa. So we want to make sure that the boys who are in our program maximize their potential. And one of the things I thought about a couple months ago was, how can we affect more kids, right? I can't take thousands of kids. I mean, I wish I could, but we just can't. And there's not a lot of mentorship programs in New Orleans. So I said, well, maybe we come. I remember when I was your age, maybe a little younger, I had these posters in my room. And I said, well, we'll develop a poster. It's kind of a Son of St. Code of Conduct. And some things we want boys to live by. Kind of 10 things that we want boys to emulate, you know, every day. They look at this poster and they can walk out and know how to live their life. And it actually came from, you know, Notre Dame when they leave to go out to the field, they touch that sign, right? That's where it came out of. So, I have posters here for each of y'all, but I want to say a little bit about Will Smith. Y'all know everything that's been going on with Will. And Will and I weren't close. I remember the first day at Millsaps College during training camp in 2006. Literally my first day, I went and got some food, and I walked over and I sat at the table by myself, and Will Smith came over along with Deuce McAllister and Reggie Bush. We had just drafted Reggie. And they sat down and we talked. And if anybody knows, some of y'all, you're a new guy, usually not going to come talk to you, right? I wasn't a football player. I just walked in there, but they all came to talk to me, and that was very important. That showed a lot about their character. And throughout that time when I was with the Saints, we got to know each other a little bit, but we weren't super close. He was actually coming to talk to our boys at the clubhouse in a couple weeks. So because at the clubhouse we have different athletes and stuff come talk to the boys and have dinner with them. And my sister knew his wife and all, but you know, it's an unfortunate incident, everything that happened. But I can tell you, before you know, all of the tests come out, I will tell you that a lot of that was resolved, conflict resolution. And if you know about conflict resolution, or if you don't know, a lot of it is learning how to, when you're confronted with something, that might be challenging, it could be another person, knowing how to see the bigger picture and not have it escalate, right, into something that could be deadly, basically. A lot of the work that I'm going to do and I'm committing myself to, and I'm having lunch today with Deuce McAllister, who's per se, because I want him to, we're going to team up and talk to kids about conflict resolution. So that's a lot of the work we do. I want to tell you one other thing. When I was at St. Aug, there was two groups of guys, right? I had one group that was pretty good, surrounded themselves with the right people, and then I had another group that didn't. And there was three guys and three guys, good and some guys that weren't doing so well. Well, one of them is in prison for the rest of his life because he murdered three people, all right? And then another one, a good friend of mine, actually, and he was a wide receiver when I was quarterback, he's paralyzed right now because he was shot, right? Wrong place, wrong time, maybe hanging around with the wrong people. And I have another guy that's in life, in jail for life also. And I have the other three guys. One of them is an attorney out here. One of them is on the St. Aug board of directors. And another one is an accountant. And I chose to hang around the guys, the good guys, right? The guys that were on my right. And it could have gone either way. And my mom raised me well, but it's all about the decisions you make. Because at a split second, you could be riding with somebody in a car and something happened. Maybe they have drugs, they have a gun, and guess what? You could have been in that situation and you could be shot just as well. So it's really about who you surround yourself with, the positives, the decisions you make, the positive decisions, but also helping out your fellow brothers and sisters in New Orleans and elsewhere. I think one of the biggest problems that we have as a black community is we don't uplift each other. You know, I think a lot of it is there's a little bit for everybody to get, so we all want to fight with each other, fight to get it. You know, there's a little bit of opportunity, so we want to fight for it, instead of creating the opportunity ourselves, right? So there's a huge responsibility from everybody in this room to really create opportunity, not only for yourself, but also for the men and women that are behind you. And that's exactly what I'm doing, that's exactly what your teachers are doing, and your coaches. They're creating opportunity for you all. And we don't want you all to lose sight of that. And you know, some kids would say, oh, well, I'm good, you know, I'm a good kid, I do well in school. That's great, well, what are you gonna do with that, right? how are you going to maximize your potential? And that's what it's all about. It's about maximizing your potential no matter where you start. So it's most important to probably the right decisions, hang around with the right crowd. Do not bully your friends and beat up on your friends and make fun of them all the time. I know y'all going to kid around because y'all are boys. That's understandable. But there's a certain space and level that you gotta really control that. You know what I mean? Because you really don't want to hurt somebody's feelings to where they may be conditioning themselves to be an angry person and then later in life do something that's not so great. And you never know, it could be because of the experiences that they had when they were your age. All right, so I want to thank you all for your time. And I have these posters over here that we'll hand out. They're pretty large, but they're great quality. And we had a local artist, his name is Nick Richard, who designed it. And the 10 things are up here that we want you all to live by. And if you need more, you contact the school, and we'll get you some more posters, all right? We're going to do a collection of these. We're going to have some more of these, probably another one at the end of the year, going into 2017. So each year we hope to do a new poster, maybe have a different artist. And we're going to pass about 5,000 of these out to kids in New Orleans. Y'all are the first ones that we're talking to because I'm invested in St. Aug. And my boys are actually going to help distribute these out, not only to you all, but throughout the city. Because part of their participation in Son of a Saint is volunteering and giving back. So thank y'all for having me. Any questions at all? I got a couple of minutes. Football, about work.
How do you join
Well, to join Son of a Saint, and I tell you, it's the boys in our program have lost their fathers, okay, and for various reasons. Now, we have, unfortunately, like I said, we don't have 1,000, we can't accept 1,000 boys. We accept 10 kids a year, 10 boys a year, and they join between 10 and 13, and they're with us to the 18. So I would say if anybody wants to be in a program and they have that background, to have your mom or your guardian or whoever fill out our application. It's online. You can fill it out through your phone. It's actually about 8 questions. It's not hard at all. It goes directly to my phone. And then I forward it on to our committee. And we all look at it at the end of the year to make our selection. All right?
Will you be involved with this?
No, actually, I didn't play football. I tell you, my dad played at Prairie View, which was a small SWAC. It was an all-black school in college in Texas. And my dad was actually an All-American. He was an All-American quarterback back in the 70s. But actually, this was about 69, 70. But the problem was he had to convert to quarterback because they weren't drafting black quarterbacks. So, and he was about 6'3", 200 pounds. So he ultimately got drafted as a defensive back. When I was here, I didn't play the whole season freshman year of football. I actually wound up playing tennis, believe it or not. I wasn't this big, but I had played tennis growing up. My mom exposed me to it, and so that's what I did. I actually did that, and I did well in my schoolwork. But my real focus here was about the work in school. It wasn't really about all the extracurricular stuff. It was really about getting my grades on point. Well, I started because everything that my mom gave me growing up, the formula that she used, is what I wanted to give back to kids in New Orleans. I mentored a boy with Big Brother, Big Sister program. I don't know if y'all are familiar with that. They actually shut operations down in Louisiana because of funding. But I had a boy that I mentored for a year. And I wanted to kind of do operate the program my way, I guess, and use kind of what I've learned and help boys. I didn't want it to be so kind of corporate, I guess. I don't know if we you get there. It's more like mom and pop, organic type program is what I've been trying to do with some of the same. But that's the real reason why, is because of the inspiration from my mom. I saw a counselor from when I was about age 8 to 17 every month. I went and talked to somebody about maybe some issues that I was having. And unfortunately, you know, some people say, oh, you're talking to a counselor, that's weak. But it helped me out a lot. The reason why I'm talking to y'all here is because of that. My mother provided a tutor for me, so I had tutoring services. There's a lot of exposure that she gave me. We went and traveled and stuff like that. So the real reason why is because of my mom, to be honest with you. Any other questions?
How does it feel to work for the Saints?
How was it to work? It was amazing to work with the Saints. It's a great organization. They do things as class grade A, man, I'll tell you. And I have a lot of friends that work for other organizations, and they'll tell you how, and just through our conversation, how blessed we are to have an organization like the Saints here in New Orleans under its leadership. You know, there's a lot of the players, you know, I got to meet a lot of them and share some great stories. But working with in the NFL and sports is very competitive. So everybody wants to work for an NFL team, right? Not everybody, but a lot of people do. And not a lot of people get that opportunity. So once you have that job, a lot of times you got to stay there because the next guy behind you is going to come and take it. And so, you know, I saw a lot of turnover. And turnover means I saw a lot of, you know, different people coming in and out. Usually in a sales team because of that. But no, it was a great organization. Anybody else? Y'all gonna have to get to class. No other questions? All right, well, look, thank y'all. And look, last question. Go ahead. All right, and look, y'all gonna have these tunes. Please do not hit each other with the tunes. All right? Do not mess up this poster. When you get it, take care of it. Take it out. You may want to have your mom or somebody else, or dad, supposed to hang it for you, and put it up in your room in a nice place. All right.